हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी स्टडी क्लास 10 साइंस चैप्टर 6 लाइफ प्रोसेसेस इंपॉर्टेंट क्वेश्चन आंसर्स।
हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू माय चैनल एनएसपी लर्निंग हब, बिकॉज लर्निंग इज लाइफ।
क्वेश्चन नंबर 1 इज व्हाई न्यूट्रिशन इज नेसेसरी फॉर ह्यूमन बॉडी। वी ऑब्टेन न्यूट्रिशन फ्रॉम फूड वी ईट। This nutrition provide us energy for survival, growth and reproduction. So, nutrition is necessary for human body. Define peristalsis and give its significance. The rhythmic contraction and relaxation of the muscles of alimentary canal is called peristaltic movement. Peristalsis mainly causes the movement of food inside the alimentary canal. Students, question number 2 is why is small intestine in herbivores longer than in carnivores? Because herbivores are plant-eating animals and plants are made up of cellulose and fibers which are not easily digested. So, for complete digestion of cellulose, they require longer digestive tract. Also, many small bacteria are present in the intestine of herbivores that help in the breakdown of cellulose into glucose. What are pseudopodia? Pseudopodias are false feet developed in some unicellular organism for movement. For example, amoeba. Question number 3 is, what will happen if mucus is not secreted by the gastric glands? The gastric glands secrete hydrochloric acid, pepsin and mucus. The mucus provides protection to the inner lining of the stomach from the action of hydrochloric acid. If mucus is not secreted by the gastric gland, it may erode the inner lining of the stomach resulting in ulcer or acidity. Most of the digestion and absorption of the food take place in the small intestine or liver, stomach or large intestine. So the answer is small intestine. Students, question number 4 is very important question. State the role of the following in human digestive system. A. Digestive enzymes, B. HCl, C. villi and D. Bile juice. Answer A. Digestive enzymes. Digestive enzymes digest the food we eat. HCl, hydrochloric acid. It creates an acidic medium to facilitate the action of enzyme pepsin. It means enzyme pepsin work in the presence of acidic mediums only. Number C. villi. Increase the surface area inside the small intestine to facilitate absorption of digested food. Number D. Bile juices. It emulsify fat to fatty acids and also neutralize the acidic food of the stomach and make it alkaline to facilitate the enzyme of pancreas. Students, question number 5 is draw a diagram of human alimentary canal and label the following. Part in which start digestion is initiated. So mouth. In mouth, with the help of salivary glands, the starch digestion is initiated. Organ in which bile is stored. In gallbladder, the bile juice is stored. The gland which secrete digestive enzymes as well as hormone. These glands are called dual nature glands and pancreas is such a gland. Part where water is reabsorbed. In large intestine, water is reabsorbed. Finger-like projections are present. In small intestine, the finger-like projections which are called villi are present for the absorption of food. This is the diagram of human alimentary canal. Mouth, liver, in which gallbladder, here bile is stored. In large intestine, water is reabsorbed and in small intestine, finger-like projections are present. It is a pancreas gland which is dual in nature stomach and esophagus. Question number 6. State the form in which the following are stored. Unused carbohydrates in plants are stored in the form of starch. And the energy derived from the food in humans are stored in the form of glycogen. When humans require energy, it changes into glucose. Describe the process of nutrition in amoeba with the help of diagram. Amoeba feeds on microorganisms which float on water. Amoeba develop false feet or pseudopodia to surround the food particles. It captures the food within a sac-like structure called food vacuole, inside which digestion of food takes place. Amoeba and it is food particles. When amoeba surround false feet or pseudopodia around the food particles and capture it and form the food vacuole. Question number 7 is, explain how are fat digested in our bodies. Where does this process take place? Fat are digested in small intestine. When food enter in small intestine, bile juice secreted by liver emulsifies fat, and then the enzyme lipase, which is secreted by pancreas, convert fat into fatty acids and glycerol. Complex molecules of fat, when act by bile juice, it is emulsification. This process is called emulsification. It change into fat globules, which is simple molecules of fat. After this, in small intestine, the pancreatic enzyme lipase digests the fat into fatty acids and glycerol. Next question is, mention the site of complete digestion in our body. Name the end product formed on complete digestion of carbohydrates, fats and proteins. The site of complete digestion in our body is small intestine. The final product produced after complete digestion of carbohydrate is glucose, protein is amino acids, and fat is fatty acids. Students, next question is, what is the difference between aerobic and anaerobic respiration? Aerobic respiration, it takes place in the presence of oxygen. Complete breakdown of food occur in it. The end product are carbon dioxide and water. For example, plants and animals take aerobic respiration. Anaerobic respiration, it takes place in the absence of oxygen. Partial breakdown of food occur in it. The end product may be ethyl alcohol and carbon dioxide in microbes or lactic acid in our muscle cells. For example, yeast and some bacteria, and also in our muscles at the time of taking exercise, anaerobic respiration take place. Students, next question is, what are the different ways in which glucose is oxidized to provide energy in various organisms? The breakdown of glucose takes place in the cytoplasm of cells of the organism. This process, which is called glycolysis, yield 3 carbon molecule compound called pyruvate or pyruvic acid. Glucose, which is 6 carbon molecule compound, when glycolysis reaction occur in the cytoplasm of the cell, the pyruvate, 2 molecules of pyruvate are formed, which are 3 carbon molecule compound. After glycolysis, which is same in all organisms, the breakdown of pyruvate take place in differently as above. Pyruvate in the absence of oxygen in bacteria and some yeast gives ethyl alcohol and carbon dioxide. And in the lack of oxygen in our muscle cells, it provides lactic acid. And in the presence of oxygen, it gives water and carbon dioxide in mitochondria in all plants and animal cells. Students, question number 11 is an important question. A cheetah, on seeing a prey, move towards him at a very high speed. What causes the movement of his muscles? How does the chemistry of cellular components of muscles change during this event? A cheetah possesses an extremely flexible spine. which allow for extreme flexion and extension while moving towards a prey at a very high speed. Rapid respiration is required for high intensity output of the chasing activity. Thus, the cheetah consequently respire anaerobically. Due to anaerobic respiration, partial breakdown of glucose takes place, which leads to the accumulation of lactic acid in the muscles as the end product. Student, our next question is, how is oxygen and carbon dioxide transported in human beings? Transport of oxygen. The hemoglobin present in RBC take place from oxygen from alveoli of lungs. The oxygen is carried by blood to all parts of the body. Transport of carbon dioxide. CO2 is more soluble in water. It is present in blood plasma as carbonate ions and as carbaminohemoglobin. Carbon dioxide is transported from body tissue to lungs, where it diffuses from blood to air in the lungs and then expelled out through nostril during exhalation. Students, our next question is, mention the three kinds of cells present in blood. Write one function of each. Blood is made up of plasma and corpuscles or cells. The three kinds of cells are RBC, WBC and blood platelets. RBC, red blood corpuscles. RBC are small biconvex cells that contain hemoglobin to transport oxygen from the lungs to the body cells and carbon dioxide from the body cells to the lungs. White blood corpuscles or WBC. The main function of WBC is defense of the body against diseases and other infections. Blood platelets. They are responsible for the clotting of blood during injuries. Students, our next question is very important question. List the three kinds of blood vessels of human circulatory system and write their functions. Three types of blood vessels in human circulatory systems are arteries, veins and capillaries. Their functions are arteries. Arteries carry oxygenated blood from hearts to various organs. They are thick walled. Veins. Veins carry deoxygenated blood from various organs to the heart. They are thin walled. Capillaries. Exchange of materials between blood and surrounding cells take place in the capillaries. They are thin-walled and extremely narrow tubes or vessels which connect arteries to veins. Students, next question is question number 15. Write one function of each of the following components of the transport system in human beings. Blood vessels, lymph and heart. Blood vessels. There are three types of blood vessels of different sizes involved in blood circulation, such as arteries, veins and capillaries, which are all connected to form a continuous closed system. Lymph. It carries digested and absorbed fat from intestine and drain excess fluid from extracellular space back into the blood. Heart. It is a pumping organ that receives blood from the veins and pumps it into the arteries. Students, next question is, in a single cell organism, diffusion is sufficient to meet all their requirements of food, exchange of gases and removal of waste. But it is not in case of multicellular organism. Explain the reason for this difference. In case of single cell organism, the entire surface of the organism is in contact with the environment and hence no specific organ for taking in food, exchange of gases and removal of waste may be needed. In case of multicellular organism, body size of the organism is large, hence all the cells are not direct contact with the environment. Thus, simple diffusion will not meet all the requirement of the cell. Students, our next question is, give reason. Fine hair and mucus is present in the nasal passages. fine hair and mucus is present in the nasal passages so that any dust particle, pathogen, etc. can be trapped here and only clean air will enter to the lungs. This is one of the defense mechanism of our body. And second one is give reason why rings of cartilage are present in the throat or trachea. From nostril, the air passes through pharynx to lungs by trachea. Incomplete C-shaped rings of cartilage are present in trachea, which ensure that the air passage does not collapse when there is no air in it. Students, next question is, why are cramps caused in our muscles during sudden activity? In our skeletal muscles, pyruvate is converted into lactic acid and energy. In the absence of oxygen, accumulation of lactic acid results in muscular cramps. Name the type of respiration that takes place in yeast during fermentation. The anaerobic respiration takes place in yeast during the process of fermentation. Students, our next question is, define excretion. The process involved in removal of nitrogen waste or harmful metabolic waste from the body is known as excretion. Name the basic filtration unit present in human kidney. Nephron is the basic filtration unit of human kidney. In human's excretory system, which part performs the following? Form urine, its kidney. A long tube which collects urine from the kidney, it is ureter. Store urine until it passed out, it is urinary bladder. Students, our next important question is, name the component of blood which transport food, carbon dioxide and nitrogen waste. Blood plasma transport food, carbon dioxide and nitrogen waste. Write the full form of ADP and ATP. ADP, adenosine diphosphate. ATP, adenosine triphosphate. Name the respiratory pigment found in human being. It is hemoglobin. Write two water conducting tissue present in plants. These are xylem vessels and tracheids.